thanks a lot for the introduction. I think, so the title of my talk is Microstrain and Temperature Sensors for Space Applications based on Graphite-PDMS Composite. This work was done with the motivation for obtaining sensors for Indian Space Research Organization's project, where they were interested in getting strain sensors, dual sensors, which can sense both strain as well as temperature, and which can be, you know, where the sensors can be kind of fabricated on conformal elastomeric substrates, so that these sensors can be wrapped onto, you know, curved surfaces for measurement along you know, spacecrafts and for such space applications. And particularly, these space applications, with regards to strain sensing, microstrain sensing was very, very interesting with regards to these applications. So this work particularly focuses developing sensors for with regards to, you know, this platform. So, the outline of my talk will go like this. I start with, you know, introduction with regards to, approaches existing for building, you know, circuits and sensors and flexible electronics. I'll also highlight some useful applications with regards to flexible electronics, specifically focusing on sensor arrays on flex. And as I mentioned, I'll briefly talk on what are the motivations behind this work as to how these sensors are being, you know, will be useful for aerospace applications. And the sensors we have developed for this application is based on percolation. And this is developed using this graphite PDMS composite. And I'll basically describe as to how to fabricate the sensor, and sensitivity to microstrains and temperature characterization will be described. And I'll conclude with what are the possible, you know, pros and cons of this approach. Yeah. So when we look at flexible electronics, with regards to approach for flexible electronics, there have been two very broad categories of which have been existing in literature. Just basically using thin film transistors based on non-crystalline semiconductors and, you know, fabricating them directly on flexible substrates. So this mostly looks like material, solving the material and device level issues for flexible electronics. And the other approach is a heterogeneous integration where we kind of package either, you know, packaged dies or bare die components, which are basically based on conventional crystalline silicon, you know, technology, and they are packaged onto elastomeric substrates with stretchable interconnections like this. Incorporating sensors and actuators on this platform will be very useful to get wearable systems that work at very high speeds, and also, you know, where wireless capabilities can be incorporated. So these are the two kind of major kind of approaches with regards to, you know, building circuits on packaging them onto, you know, flexible substrates. When you come to, you know, applications of sensor arrays for flexible electronics, you can see that wearable healthcare devices, you know, these using this platform, building or packaging electronics onto elastomers with sensors is very useful with regards to wearable healthcare devices, where vital parameter monitoring pulse, pressure, temperature, etc., onto these elastomers help to develop clinical diagnostic gadgets, which is used for both clinical sensing as well as, you know, treatment. And other areas include putting a large number of sensors and actuators onto, you know, skin-like substrates, so that they can be used for robotic applications where you develop artificial skin for robotics. And you know, similar application include developing sensors and actuators on such flex skin-like substrates, which can be used for prosthetic implants to give, you know, sensory perceptions to the, you know, prosthetic. And other applications include using piezoelectric harvesting, which is then based on having, you know, a PVDF sensors on flexible substrates, so that, you know, where energy harvesting is possible. And this is the application which we are targeting with regards to this research work, which is basically you're using conformal sheets where sensors are built on them, so that they can be used for parameter measurement along curved surfaces. It's basically for surfaces like launch vehicles and spacecrafts. Yeah, so this is a very quick review of what different kinds of approaches or methodologies are existing in literature with regards to building strain sensors and temperature sensors on elastomers. A few approaches include using fragmentized carbon nanotube and PDMS composite, and this is with regards to strain sensing. And also, a few approaches use optical sensors, which is building waveguides on guided light beams on elastomers, you know, to kind of measure strain. And another approach uses three-dimensional graphene foam material, where, you know, sensitivity to strain can be measured. And similar approaches exist for temperature sensors, like where temperatures have been built using amorphous semiconductor-based TFT pixels. And the other approach uses screen-printed thermistors on flex substrate like PET, and using organic, organic TFTs for temperature sensing is another approach. So this is a very quick review as to what kind of approaches exist for strain and temperature measurements on flexible substrates. And like I'll again quickly talk about what is the driving motivation for this work as a brief during the introduction. Just like strain and temperature, very important parameters for measurement along curved surfaces of launch vehicles and spacecrafts. Especially with regards to strain, a range of 0 to 10,000 microstrain, if you can get sensors in this microstrain range, that will be very great for these applications. And the key challenge here is to operate sensors such that the conductivity or the sensitivity is very high within this strain range. So that is the main key challenge which has been solved with regards to this research. And our solution for this problem is like we are tackling this problem based on percolation-based sensors using optimized graphite PDMS composite. This is the architecture which has been used for the sensor, which basically consists of it's basically resistance-based sensing, where we sense the resistance change across these copper electrodes, which are spaced by a distance d. And the structure is made of a composite layer of three composite layers of this PDMS graphite composite. And I'll explain as to what is novel with regards to this architecture in the next slide. And the whole sensor architecture is built on a 10:1 PDMS substrate, where both the microstrain and temperature for characterization, these are exerted onto this 10:1 PDMS substrate. So what are the key novel elements of the sensor? Is to like the main experiment or optimization with regards to these three parameters. You have this architecture, like experiments were performed as to what is the best weight ratio, which is for this graphite PDMS composite, such that strain sensitivity lies within this 0 to 10,000 microstrain range. And also the elastomer cross-linker ratio, which is basically for this composite layer, the PDMS is prepared using different elastomer cross-linker ratios. And that can give rise to different mechanical strengths, which basically changes the Young's modulus of the elastomer layer. So based on experiments, it has been optimized that 4:1 works well to get the desired mechanical strength, such that the whole sensor operates within this strain range. So that is the second parameter which has been optimized. And thirdly, the electrode spacing for this architecture, the electrode spacing has been optimized based on experiments. And it has been observed that the sensor, for the optimized electrode spacing with regards to this sensitivity range, the strain sensor conducts almost 14 milliamps of current for a 5-volt DC bias applied across the electrodes. I'll just quickly go as to what is the fabrication process for this sensor. This is then based on broadcasting of the optimized 4:1 PDMS graphite composite onto a glass substrate to form a layer, and it is not cured at this stage. Following the copper electrodes are aligned onto this layer with a spacing d, and experiments have been done repeatedly using starting with a minimum separation of 1 mm based on iterations, and the final optimum electrode spacing has been obtained. And on top of this copper electrodes, another 4:1 PDMS graphite composite is again broadcasted to get the whole sensor architecture. And at this stage, the sensor is, the conductivity between the two electrodes is checked to check for possible current conduction through the sensor. And after which, curing of PDMS is done. And this gives the whole structure. It's basically this composite structure with the copper electrodes aligned onto that. And finally, the whole sensor layer is transferred onto 10:1 PDMS substrate to get the final. And this shows the micrograph of the sensor fabricated. And this works for large applications, substrate is very large, and it's used for space applications too, so that the substrate area is kept very large here. And it shows that conformability of the sensor to curved surfaces. And quickly, I'll just go through as to what gives strain sensitivity here. You have this composite material which is having PDMS and graphite in this ratio, which is basically 0.546 to 0.54, you can see that you can think this has a mesh consisting of many graphite and PDMS element sitting like this. This gives rise to many conductive chains between the electrodes, which have been indicated as A and B here. So like with regards to stretching, this leads to breaking of chains within the this mesh, which kind of increases the resistance of the sensor, and that gives to strain sensitivity. And this is the setup used to measure the sensitivity of the sensor with regards to microstrains. So microstrain is applied using a computerized module, and using a UTM, the sensor is stretched to different levels of microstrains to measure these resistance change across the electrodes. And this shows the sensitivity of the plot for different different samples. And when this shows the sensitivity when the sensor is repeated for different trials for the same sample. So the error bars in the graph represent trial to trial variations, and the resist sample to sample variation is a little larger in this approach due to the randomness which is inherently existing within the percolation chains. So this is the temperature sensitivity setup, and you can see that sensitivity temperature is almost linear with up to a temperature of 60 degrees, after which the temperature kind of increases exponentially. And additional characterizations were performed to check whether vibrations have any impact with regards to the sensor performance. It was observed that within a frequency, audio frequency range of 50 hertz to 500 hertz, the sensor did not pick up AC signals with regards to these frequencies, but there was only a shift in the DC current that flowed through the sensors at different frequency values. And another important characterization with regards to what is the impact of bending itself on the inherent resistance, that is at the zero strain resistance, on the sensor. And you can see that wrapping it to different radius of curvature, this is the change in the DC, change in the resistance value at zero strain. Yeah, so like I would like to conclude the talk by saying that this sensor is developed based on this composite elastomer material, which is optimized based on these three ratios, which is basically the weight ratio of the PDMS graphite composite, and also the elastomer cross-linker ratio, which sets the mechanical strength of the elastomer layers, and the conformability of the substrate, which is useful for building large area sensor arrays for aerospace applications, so that parameters can be measured along curved surfaces. Future works include tailoring the sensitivity of the sensor by using different materials or novel materials and methods, so that you can tailor to it a particular sensitivity value, and also novel structures to reduce the sample to sample variations which is existing within the in the percolation chains in these sensors. And when such large area arrays are packaged onto elastomer with associated electronics, this will help to build sensors which are which can wirelessly transmit signals for aerospace applications.
Thank you very much.
So I would like to thank ISRO for this project, which is Indian Space Research Organization, Space Technology Center located at IASC, who have funded this project. And also I thank everyone for your patience.
Any questions? Thank you very much. We have time for questions.